Erzählung. Das flackert an die Seite.
Hi everybody, my name is James Park. I live in Wensfield, just down the road in Wolverhampton. I'm here today to talk to you about WV11.co.uk, which is a hyper-local website founded by myself and my girlfriend Steph. She's down at the pop-up shop at the moment, harassing shoppers from my name, so hopefully that's going well. For those who don't know, a hyper-local website is a website aimed at a specific geographic area. It could be a street, it could be an estate, an entire city. In our case, this site is aimed at the wards of Wensfield North and South of Wolverhampton, and the name relates to our postcode, which is WV11. Myself and Steph set up the site 3 years ago, mainly with the motivation that there wasn't a lot going on online in the area, and a lot of people in the area we felt didn't really give it credit for what was going on, so we decided we'd create somewhere online that we could talk about what was going on, ask people their views, and generally try and create some kind of online civic engagement of a sort. We don't have any journalistic backgrounds, so we're just citizens who report on what happens in our neighbourhood. Over time, say it's been going 3 years, we've built up quite good relations with the City Council, with Westminster Police, various community organisations, and in doing that, a byproduct of doing that rather, has been what people like to call social capital. I call social capital the community spirit. Essentially, that's what it is. There's been a number of examples of how the social capital or community spirit has built up over this time, has benefited people in the area, and also how those people have been able to help other people. I'm going to run through just a couple of those briefly. As you all know, last summer, the riots began in London and spread to the Midlands, affected Wolverhampton, and there was kind of 48 hours where the world seemingly went mad, certainly around Wolverhampton. We had a whole day of rumours online about trouble, where the trouble was, if there was trouble, what might be happening. Myself and Steph spent about 16 hours that day shooting down rumours online. People were coming to our Facebook page, contacting on Twitter, saying, is this happening, has that happened? We had reports of shopping centres being burned down, to which we said, look out your window, can you see smoke? Fortunately, it hadn't been burned down. There was actually very little trouble in Wensfield at all, and what did happen was in the city centre and was minimised greatly by the police. Another example of how that helps people gain knowledge about what was actually happening, because at the time there wasn't a lot of information coming out from the media or anywhere else, and so all of a sudden we found ourselves inundated with rumours and questions and we were having people to go to find out. Back end of last year, there was a house fire in Wensfield. First thing we knew, this was somebody posted on our Facebook page saying there was a house fire, so the fire engine's attendance. Within a few hours of this happening, we'd have reports of people coming on saying they knew the family whose house had been damaged in the fire. And a few hours after that, we had the person whose house had burned down pop on our Facebook page and basically thank everybody for showing their concern. The lady whose house had burned down was actually on holiday with her three daughters and had to drive back from somewhere in Wales to come home and basically find that all they had was the belongings in their car from their holiday because they lost everything in this house fire. We spoke to them very briefly over email and said that we'd like to try and help if we can. We put an appeal out online on our Facebook page, on our website, on Twitter, asking for real basic things such as clothes. We've got the shoe sizes of the children because they literally lost everything. Immediately we had offers of stuff coming in, we need to find somewhere to take this stuff. So we spoke to the local church, Thomas's in Wensfield, who arranged stuff to be dropped off at the church. So we put a message up online saying, if you've got anything that you'd like to donate to help these people, please do drop it off here. And within, I think it was 24 hours, we had a phone call from the church saying, you need to come pick this stuff up, we haven't got room to run our Sunday school club. They had over a dozen, in 24 hours, over a dozen bin liners full of stuff, be it clothes, shoes, toys, everything for this lady and her family. So we drove down there, filled the car up, and then filled our living room up with belongings. We got quite a lot of interest from the local radio station, so they called us up and asked us what happened. And we didn't set out to start some kind of grand appeal. It was literally just we just asked online, can anyone help? We were inundated. The family had an offer of a month's free rent in accommodation. They had offers of furniture. see that completely unintentionally this kind of social capital is really getting, we built up over a couple of years, actually coming to action. This was yet an online website that talked about the area, but it enabled people in the area to help other people in the area who were in need. And yeah, to anyone that says community spirit is dead or disappearing in Britain, I will say this disputes that. That's what we do. If you want to check us out online, all the details are up there. And great to see this event taking place.